I don't think they're gonna be hitting on top wire, so I'm not gonna bring too many. I will probably bring that GT metal right there though. Alright, so the loadout for today is, I'm not gonna be bringing everything, but it will be quite a bit. It's gonna be bringing some Kytex, Curly Tail, Grubs, and Flukes. I'm gonna be bringing some Paddle Tail Flukes as well. That's mainly what I'll be using today. I'm gonna bring some Bug Tails, 2 ounce so I can get out there because I'll be on shore. Some bank sinkers, some more jigs that I can use to set up and get out. So, and I'm probably gonna be throwing an A-rig. Yeah, this is an old A-rig right here, if you guys can see that. Besides that, I'm just gonna be bringing whatever is in this tackle box right here. Some top waters, another A-rig, some S-wavers, more jig heads. And a super loaded spook right here. Thanks to Hybrid Killer for giving me that. Little tip, if you guys have like a CRV or, you know, or like a smaller SUV or a big SUV, this is one way I store my rods while I'm driving. This is an 8-foot surf rod, but I got these straps just going across right here. One going across right here, one going across to the front. And that just, you know, keeps your rod out and away from your passengers or yourself. This is where I'll be going right here. Let's see. Come on, keep going. That is Keystone Dam right there. This guy on first. This is just a bucktail with a broken hook, and from there I've tied a leader like that to a fluke. This is a 4-0 swim bait hook, no weight on the hook, and I'm just gonna throw it out there to keep it weightless, and that will help me from snagging all the rocks and extra strings at the bottom. So, I'm gonna be using this setup. This is my Dallas Tega on a TFO surf rod. Any luck? Try it here first. Thank you.
hay at the bottom. Might have to change out to a heavier weight. This is my bucktail right here. It's not really touching the bottom like I want it to. It's casting out decently far though. I have to go down river. Try down there in a bit. Checking a new spot. Right here should be good. cut. Look at that. Could have been a gar that hit. There's a bunch of gar in here. Alright, so moved downriver. Looks like it's not biting up at the dam. I was out there for like an hour. Had a hit. A couple people catching white bass. But I don't want to catch the striper, so we're gonna go down here. Yeah, how deep was it? 6 feet? Oh, okay. We'll be right back.
Hey guys, it's gonna be my outro to my video because I didn't record one yesterday, but basically skunked, as you guys can see, sucks. They had the water on all day, and I knew before going out there that, you know, we could skunk, and it happened. It's fine. We did find a pattern that worked, had a couple bites, but it was, we figured out kind of too late, I think. And on top of that, we only had one casting bobber, and that broke off after like 20 casts, so that sucked. And then we hiked all the way back to the car. But yeah, if you guys like this video, I hope to make more, and you know, subscribe to the video, click that little notification button, so every time I upload a video, you'll get notified. And just want to say thanks for watching, and I'll see you on the next one.